Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you prediction of range performance with radar system. See, range performance prediction that is done with the use of receiver of radar system. In this video, I'll explain you how exactly that process is happening. In my earlier videos, I have derived maximum range of radar equation. If you see that equation, then in that equation, I have derived this, where maximum range of radar, that is PTGAE sigma divided by 4 pi square into S mean and whole to the power 1 by 4. Here PT, that is transmitted power of antenna. So here with radar system, we transmit high power signal. That signal is there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts. So here we transmit high power signal with the use of antenna. Here, this G is gain of transceiver antenna. Usually, with radar system, we use parabolic dish antenna. Parabolic dish antenna gain calculation that one can do with the use of this equation. That is, G is equals to 4 pi AE by lambda square. Here, AE is effective area of parabolic dish antenna and lambda is wavelength. If you have been given with operating frequency, then wavelength can be calculated as per f is equals to c by lambda. So lambda will be c divided by f. So once you have wavelength, once you have effective area, then you can easily calculate gain of parabolic dish antenna. Here, see sigma, that is target cross sectional area. I have already made separate video based on how to identify target cross section. Right now consider target cross section area that is given in terms of meter square. But usually there is a process of identification of target cross sectional area based on reflection of energy from the target. If you want to understand that, then you just go through my video lecture series of radar engineering, in which I have made separate video based on target cross section. Right now consider target is having cross sectional area of sigma that is there in terms of meter square. Lambda is operating wavelength and S mean, that is minimum detectable signal. See, with radar system, we will be receiving very weak echo signal. And that weak signal is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. And that weak signal, which is received by antenna, that will be given to receiver circuit, and receiver circuit will be taking decision of range of the target. So at last, receiver takes decision of location of target. Now I'll explain you how it will take decision. So for that, you need to understand one scenario. Here, see radar range prediction that is done with the use of receiver, where based on minimum detectable signal, we will be identifying range prediction, where we will be considering threshold voltage for prediction of range. Let me take one scenario. Here we are having one antenna, and with the use of this antenna, we will be identifying location of target 1, target 2 and target 3. Here you can observe target 1, that is there at distance R1, means range of target 1, that is R1, range of target 2, that is R2, and range of target 3, that is R3. Now, how we can identify range? So first of all, this radar system that will be transmitting high power signal in the direction of target. And once that high power signal goes towards target, obviously there will be reflected echo signal. So reflected echo signal that will go towards antenna again. And based on echo signal received by this antenna, inside radar system, there is receiver which will be taking decision of range prediction of this target. So here received signal that is very weak, and at last there will be decision making box. That decision making box will be taking decision whether target exists or not. Let me explain you how to have that decision making. See, at last in radar system we will be having decision making box that is having this type of signal, where on y-axis we will be having voltage and on x-axis we will be having time. Now, if you observe the characteristic of this signal, then in this characteristic of the signal, you can clearly observe here we are having three peaks. Out of these three peaks, whether target is existing or not, that decision is taken based on comparison of threshold. Here, if you observe, see this horizontal line that explains you RMS value of noise. So there is always noise that is received by this antenna. So operator will have to take decision. What should be the threshold value of decision making voltage? So here, see RMS value of noise that is always there. So operator should not select threshold value somewhere nearer to noise. Otherwise, radar will be detecting false targets, right? Here, see this first peak that belongs to target one, this second peak that belongs to target two, and this third peak that belongs to target three. If you properly observe this waveform, then you see target one that is nearer to antenna. As it is nearer to antenna, here voltage of target one that is bit higher compared to target two. And as target two is nearer compared to target three, voltage of target two that is bit higher compared to target three, right? So here, if you observe this peak that belongs to these different targets, but how radar is taking decision? Radar takes decision based on threshold value. So here operator will be selecting some threshold voltage, and by comparing given signal with threshold voltage, we will be identifying whether target exists or not. Like as if this threshold voltage is this much, which is there as per this green line. Then at this instant, we are having time duration T1, which explains you existence of target one. And at this instant, let us say this is time duration T2, then there is existence of target two after duration T2. And after duration T3, target three is existing over here, right? So threshold decision will be taking decision whether a target is existing or not. And once threshold is taking decision, if threshold is taking decision over here, like here a target is existing, then by having a calculation of time duration, one can calculate what is the distance R, right? And that calculation even I have explained in my earlier videos, where range is equals to CT/2, where C is velocity of light, T is duration of that round trip time, and D/2 that you need to do. Why D/2 that you need to do? The reason is signal is propagating by 2R distance. First it is getting transmitted, after that it is getting reflected back to antenna. So it will be traveling by R plus R, 2R distance. That's why equation is CT/2, right? And this threshold decision that is been considered as per the comparison of given voltage with waveforms, right? Now here operator's role, that is very critical over here. You need to understand that. See, operator will have to see what should be the threshold voltage. As if operator is choosing threshold voltage with higher value, then target may not be identified over here. Like as if you select this line by higher voltage, then here it is possible that you may not be able to detect these targets, right? Even you cannot select threshold voltage to be lower. If you select threshold voltage to be lower, then noise may be considered as a target over here. So you don't need to consider noise as a target, right? So threshold should be there in between the voltage which is not high as well as the voltage that should not go towards noise over here, right? So operator will be taking decision of threshold voltage, and based on that, range prediction is happening. So that is how complete process is happening for range prediction. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.